Students, welcome to the food and beverage online session. The topic that today I'm going to cover would be planning and operating various food and beverage outlets. This is the fifth semester unit of the food and beverage operation one. Now, when we say talk about planning and operating various food and beverage outlets, it doesn't talk about one type of outlet, but it talks about different types of outlets. Okay, now in this topic, what we are going to cover would be introduction to the physical layout. It will talk about objective, the layout of the restaurant. It will talk about physical layout of a pantry. That would be a prototype, how the pantry would look like. And in this last and the least that we are going to discuss would be international space requirement in different catering establishments. It means, suppose it is a coffee shop, how much would be a space required per person in a restaurant. And likewise, we'll talk about different types of establishments requirement. Now let's talk about introduction to the physical layout of the, or we can talk objective. It talks about that every restaurant has a practical aspect. It means every restaurant differ from each other based on the practical aspect. Talks about in the sense of how the restaurant will look like, how practical the restaurant would be in terms of character, its ambience and its layout. This is what it talks about in terms of the introduction to the restaurant layout. Now, if you look at the picture out here, you will find there is one detective with a magnifying glass and he is searching the restaurant. It is similar to a guest nowadays, where the guest prefer to choose a restaurant to dine, keeping in mind the practicality of the restaurant, the ambience of the restaurant, the character of the restaurant and the menu, and how good the review of that particular restaurant is in the particular social media. The other way around, if you look at the left hand side on the somewhere in the center, you will find there is M written. Now it is a trademark of a given restaurant. So every restaurant has got a trademark, and based on the trademark, the customer prefers to go to a restaurant. The trademark here is M. M means McDonald's out here. It's the international fast food joints, which caters to the kids and to the teenagers and the school going kids, as well as the people, those who go to the office, those who are in the hurry and they want to munch their food. This is what it talks about in terms of the introduction to the restaurant layout. Now let's move forward and talk about the objective of the layout of a restaurant. The objective of the layout of the restaurant, the first thing it says that the guest needs and expectations are supposed to be met by the layout of the restaurant. If the guest is satisfied and is with the expectation of a restaurant, then he is happy to go out there. Now it says the dining area should be flexible enough. It means in case any changes that is being required in a given restaurant, there a change can happen. For example, suppose we have two tables of six each and there is one reservation of a guest who has around 10 people coming along with him. So the restaurant needs around 10 to 12 covers set up for a given guest booking, so that two six cover tables can club together and could be converted to 10 or 12 cover restaurant. We all know that every restaurant has their own appeal and ambience, keeping in mind the requirement of the restaurant decor or the theme of the restaurant. So it is all based on the ambience. A person decide whether I should go to this restaurant or not. Now land is something which is a very costly commodity. So we also have to look at the aspects of the requirement of the stakeholders in terms of the return on investment. So we have to plan the restaurant in such a way that the maximum space is being utilized so that maximum revenue could be generated to the given restaurant. Now it says that a practical layout ensures an efficient flow of staff members and guests within dining areas. So the restaurant layout should be practical enough, should be efficient, should be planned in such a way that the traffic flow of the guests and the service staff takes in the right way. Now the SOP that is being created should be very clear in terms of the layout. It should be very simple so that it becomes easy for the staff members to perform their task. Now the dining area should be safe and sound both for the staff members and for the guest, because if the guest and the staff are satisfied, they would be able to provide business in terms of the guest, and the service staff would be free to provide good service to the staff member, to the customer, so that the customer are happy while with the service. Now we are living in a COVID. Prior to the COVID era also, the sanitization and sanitation of the restaurant was of utmost importance. It should be always spick and span. So today also we talk about sanitation. It means that restaurant should be sanitized and it should be clean and clear and should be free of disinfectants. Now the dining area should have a low maintenance cost, because if the tables, chairs and the layout are being done in the proper way, the chances of the damage of the property would be less. The dining area should be energy efficient and ecologically sound. It means the dining area should use the maximum natural light so that the artificial light consumption could be reduced and it could be used for the higher revenue generation to the establishment. Now it says the dining area are designed to support the service staff and efficient operations. It means dining areas are designed in such a way that the service that is being provided by the service staff takes place in the right manner without any disturbances, which helps in providing the very good service to the guest, which somehow caters to the wow factor to the guest as well as to the restaurant. Now if you look at the picture out here, this is a picture of a McDonald's restaurant. Now if you look at the picture, you'll find that the restaurant looks very it's very lively, I would say, where different color patterns are being used. The light intensity is harsh or hard, I would say. The sitting area that we say is of a very good stature, but it is not very that comfortable in nature. It means, and there is a counter out there from where the food is being displayed. You go to the counter, you order your food, the service counter boy take the money from you and provide you the food and the drink that you require. You either sit on the different tables sitting that is being done out there, or you carry that food in the pouch or in the packet which is being given by the McDonald's team, and you munch up your food. This is one outlet in terms of the McDonald's restaurant. The next outlet talks about our fine dining restaurant. If you find out here, the covers are being laid out, the distance between two tables are more, the comfort is being looked after in the utmost manner, the tables are with tablecloths, the sitting is very comfortable in nature. The third picture, if you look at, is very lively in color. You will find lots of red color, yellow, green tinge, very lively. This is a very it's conceptual based restaurant. It is it could be a Chinese restaurant, Japanese, Thai, Korean, Singaporean or Malaysian. So the restaurant, it is a Pan-Asian restaurant which deals with this all different types of cuisine that you have talked about, and they cater to this. So you more or less, if you go to any of the Pan-Asian restaurant, or Thai, Chinese or Japanese or Korean or North Korean or Singaporean restaurant, you'll find this kind of conceptual based setup out there. Now let's move forward. Now you look at the picture out here. It is a layout of a pantry. This is a prototype of layout of pantry, how the pantry look like. We all know pantry is something which is located in the back area of the restaurant, from where your food that is not being provided by the kitchen team, you get it from here. In terms of pastries, in terms of ice cream, you need any shakes, you need the sandwiches, you need salads. So this is what, from where you get these all food commodity for a given restaurant. So the pantries are being laid out in this fashion, in this manner, so that it can provide the service in a smooth manner. So you'll find out here, you have a storage shelving areas, you have a sideboard, you have salad washings, you have refrigerator which is very reachable, you have a work table where you can cut your foods, you have a slicer machine, you have a sandwich maker. Okay, so these all commodities are being set up in such a manner inside the layout form for a pantry for the smooth operation to the given restaurant. Let's move forward to the next slide. The next slide talks about international space requirements. It is very important, because when we do the layout of a restaurant, we should be aware how much space would be required per person in a given restaurant. So different space requirement is based on different types of restaurant that we will be dealing in. So in case we have a counter style service, so in that scenario, the requirement is 10 to 12 square feet per person. In case it is a coffee shop, so we need 13 to 15 square feet per person. If it is, suppose it is fine dining restaurant, then we need 18 to 20 square feet area per person. For a banquet function which is informal in nature, we need 10 square feet area, and in case it is like a state banquet or a formal banquet, in that scenario we need a space between 13 to 15 square feet area. This is the international space requirement per person inside a given restaurant. This deals with per person. When it talks about number of customer, it talks about in terms of customer. So this is what it talks about in terms of the physical layout of the restaurant, how it should look like, what will point we need to cover. We also looked at the aspects of the pantry. We also have looked at the aspects of the different space that is being required in different restaurant per guest. This is what it talks about.